Hello everyone, accept greetings from Serpent Consulting Services Private Limited. Here this time around we are going to contribute a very nice module, a very nice profile with a nice module called Field Service Management. This is, service is a very good expression for the self-expression of the society. And you know, it's very important for any service company to handle everything in an automated way for their customers to serve. So here with that idea coming into mind, Serpent CS has planned out a very nice module as a feature, as a whole application, which will give you an option to list out all your services into a mobile application. And this particular module can be operated by three kind of roles. The first role is a customer. A customer can request services to you when you are a service provider. They can also use the system using a mobile application. They can even provide, you can use a portal service of Odoo and put up the service request into your system. Second is operator. When the customer is handling a call, giving a call to you, and your operator is taking the call and get the request, he can configure the same service request into the system as well. That's FSM. The third option of using it, it's the role of serviceman. The way Ola cabs and Uber cabs are having taxi drivers using the application, same way servicemen can also access the whole system by an application, by a mobile application. For the same, we have planned out two ways. This is the customer can operate it by the either the portal way or the mobile application way. The operator and servicemen, the operator can handle again by the mobile application way and the particular application way. Servicemen of course can do the same, but more he will be using service record by the mobile application, because there are location tracker and services which are very useful for them to handle the information of the customer, picking up the pictures of the service and so on. So going forward, let's just go to the mobile application, how the mobile application works. At the same time, we will see parallelly how the field service management is there. Just giving you an idea about the features, as you can see, with this you can manage the various jobs of the servicemen. You can have automatic assignment of the jobs. For example, the nearest serviceman to the area, based on the area and the zone of the particular service and the availability of the serviceman, you can automatically assign a particular job to a serviceman. Second is configure services. Whatever services you have configured into your particular FSM record system, all those services will be available into the mobile application into a separate view. You can always create invoices. You can just send invoices to your customer by email, by WhatsApp, by whatever medium. When you are already using an Android application, you can have an express service option. In many service criterias, there are options that someone wants a service very quickly, so that some special rates can always be provided per hour or per day or so on. So that's for that there is a specific service rate given. You can always have a localization. You can configure that on which zone, which state, which city, which area the services are supposed to be provided. Based on that, the availability of a serviceman can be assured. So that's again a possibility within our FSM solution. Of course, when we have Odoo, you have a very nice analysis system, reporting system. So you can consider easily to see your reports, your reporting, your BI view, your pivot charting, that what are the best areas you are serving to the customers and what are the areas your customers are giving you a good, very good feedback about, and you can have the analysis and so on. So let's simply go to the services and let's configure the various services we have. This is a dashboard for admin. This is actually a backend system, so admin or the particular serviceman can take a look, what are my jobs, what are the total jobs, what are unassigned jobs, rejected invoicing parts and so on. So let's look at the services. At the same time, we will go through the mobile application as well. I am handing over the mobile application. Here we have a FSM, this field service management. I am clicking on it. When I click on it, it is giving us an access whether we want to sign up as a new user. So you can choose whether the serviceman is getting logged in or whether the particular service, the customer is getting logged in. So I will go to the particular home. I will go to sign in first. I will connect to the server 0.5, and this is my server. I'm going to log in. First, let me log in as a customer, just to give you an overview. So I'm going to log in as a customer, as you can see. When I'm logging as a customer, I will be able to see, let me check, I will log in, try again. Okay, I'm connected, that's perfect. Let me log in. As soon as I'm logged in, I will be able to see what are the, I'm as a customer, so I will be able to see what are the service criterias are there. What are the various services that the Serpent company provide? So I can use a service and I can log in a request. Whenever I am logged in, I will be able to see all my dashboard. That is the current list of services you see, my request, all my requests which are given in the past, and I can even see the status of each request, whether something is done or something is in the progress, something is a new request, something is cancelled, and so on. So I can easily do the same. Let's take a look, for example, for the housekeeping services, which is given by me in the past to them. So I can see what is the service, or I can even see with the service I have given to the particular company, what are the time sheets has it been entered? I mean, what are the time entered by the serviceman for my service? What are the job lines means? What are the particular items I have bought, if any, with my service? Let's say if I'm doing the housekeeping, I might need to buy washer or so on. If I'm going for the service call of a mobile, I might need to buy a cover or a screen or so on. So that job line will be product lines for me. It will become a customer invoice when I, it will be used in the customer invoice when I'm going to create invoice as a customer. So when there is a map, so it will also guide my salesman that where I'm located. So based on the location configuration here, it's a live record given to the customer that, hey, you could be at whatever location and it will take you 29 kilometers and 44 minutes to reach my location, and there's a map given to you. So that's this is the application I'm using as a customer. So that's it. Let me go back to the various service areas. Let's say I wish to register a service request for vehicle repair. Here I have an option that if I am going to repair from the current location, or if I am creating this request as a third party and giving another location. So when I, let's go for example for the current location. The current location will automatically be identified based on the parameters. Of course, GPS location, I have to keep the GPS location on. Let's say I have to give a request there. It's a car breakdown. Description. Sudden tire burst and my number is this. So as soon as I'm also able to create a specific picture of my particular tire. Let's say I'm trying to create a picture. Let's see, if I click on the camera, it will give me an option whether you want to take a photo, you want to choose from library. Let's try to choose from a library of my system. If I can send a specific demo picture. Let's say, for example, this particular phone I'm picturing, and I have no car in the picture. But let's consider my particular picture for the display. Okay, it's updated, so I will just submit a request. Whenever as a customer I am submitting a request, I will go into the FSM application, and if there is automatic assignment, my job will be assigned to a specific serviceman. Now into the backend, I am checking and looking at the services. My services would be created, and let's take a look. The job number automatically is there. So as you can see in the screen, this new job is created, saying that the job number is this, and the push notification will tell me that who is assigned to the particular who is the assigned person for me. So for vehicle repair, I can in the backend, the operator can choose who is the best person. Here, based on the serviceman, there are skills which are given. Based on the skills, the assigned person will come. Let's say if I'm choosing the different service, for example here, the whoever are the servicemen assigned to this skill will appear here in the domain filter. So I can see my location is logged out, my hours is there, my description is logged out, my timesheet can be taken care of as well. And also I can see the attachment can be found here as well. So every track of the service can also be tracked. So my request from this mobile application has been logged already, and I can look at the particular section. So I can even see if there are any suggested salesmen, they can suggest me for the salesman. I can notify the customer, I can send an email. As in background application user, I can send an email to the customer. I can even create the invoice if there are any specific, there is no employee assigned, so that's why the turn is there. So let me just try to assign a specific service repair criteria. Let's go to service. I can configure that for this service, what are the possible assignees we can choose. Let's go to the vehicle repair. I can see that settings for the vehicle repair. I can see these are the options, these are the customers, these are the icons we can choose, these are the working time. It's possible that some electronic repair, some AC repair can be only in the daytime, while the vehicle repairs and some housekeeping can always be 24/7. So you can always choose a time scheduling for the same. and this is the sequence that will let you choose the sequence of the service display. Let's say if I change the sequence to be 1, the vehicle repair will appear on the top on my mobile application. So I will first I will go to the employees list of my employees, and I will choose a particular let's say I will choose Antoine. There is a relation I have to manage, so I will better use Peter Parker as one. Okay, again I have again the relationship XM, so I will go to the specific old record of my jobs where I can always have fixing. Yeah, there's a guest house cleaning always there. It's assigned to a specific serviceman and the address is given as well. Let me choose a create invoice option. Not to employees, that's a concern. So this always a criteria. Of course I can choose whoever is the person I am going to pick for the whatever services. Let me change the service for a while and see if the right person is assigned for me. Let's save it. I'm creating the invoice here. When the invoice is created, I will be able to see whatever is the time spent and what is the service time of the employee. So what happens if there is a specific configuration of the time given, if there is any timesheet assigned to the person, this timesheet, this number of time will be occupied into the invoice. So let's say I'm spending a time of tasting time 2 hours assigned. I should go for open invoice. Right now it's not there, but if I cancel the invoice, I should be able to find out the working solution. Let me go back. It's not allowing me. Let me duplicate the record for a while, so it will allow me whether the with the entries. Yes, let me try to sort it out. Try. So this is the time based entries, so it will always look up for the entries. Oh, not again. I should better create a new record for the same, so let it go get the this customer. Oh, sorry, for the cleaning I'll create a job that, for example, the job is created, let's say test job, and my request is for, let's say, for plumbing. It's being assigned to whatever user, the customer is whoever, and I can choose the area and so on. Let's say I'm creating entry of the admin. It is spent time for fixing the stuff. Let's say I spent 4 hours. I'm saving the record, and when I'm saving the record and just creating the invoice, it will create the invoice with a specific time. So 4 hours have been spent. This is the unit price specified in the administrator. So that the salesman, you always have an express price list and a basic price is given. Based on that, you will always have the price, the invoices for you. Here you can always see in the customers. You can always see what are the allocation of who are the users, your customers. For our specification, we have planned out each user will have a very specific customer ID or serviceman ID and so on. We have just tested out it very well. On the FSM, you can always have the analysis of the jobs. What are the jobs are going to give you, or are the costing, you can always download it. You can always have a specific nice view. You can always change that what are the criteria you want to see on the job analysis and so on. So and I will, we can even see the status of it. Let me go to the home. We can see the status of our request. Let's say my request given was, let's say, a house one on a vehicle repair part. These are the status. I can always see the job line if it is assigned. Let me take whatever the job. The job was, give me a moment. Let's look at the job. I can assign from the background as well. That's again a kind of a push notification standard. This is the one I can assign. Let me choose the customer as Jay. So you can see in the background it will happen for me. So it should be able to drop down and give me this plumbing test application. I can see what are the time spent. I can see the job line. If there is any product bought, it will be available over here. These are the details of the task. So this way out, you can always use the field service management, and it will give you a nice interface with the fact that you can always have an option that to list all your services into a mobile application, and all these services into mobile application will always be listed out into the background backend as with this. And you can always take a look at what are the products you have. You can take a look at the best application options. you can specify the localization. Based on that, you can choose what are the areas you are providing services, what are the zones you are providing services. You can have the country group decided. Based on that, you can have a skills. When you go and check the option of a specific customer, specific partner, you will be able to find out that what are the options. Right now it's not opening for some reason. but when you see, there will be a skills option, so that let's say a customer employee Antoine, this employee Antoine is a plumber as well as the housekeeper. So whenever you are using the service choice of option on the housekeeping part, when this particular service is assigned, it will only be assigned to a specific option, either Antoine or Giles, I mean those options who are in the plumbing option. So this way out, the field service management is going to help you out in various ways. This section is totally dynamic. Whatever services you assign on the FSM part, all those configuration will be affected on the mobile application. So overall, this field service management we have made as a framework that can be helped to a technical serviceman, the mobile serviceman, the bill collectors, the dispatcher guys, the people who are the medical representatives as well, of course, and those who are, let's say, government supplier employees who are going to door to door, the taxi men as well, and so on. So for all technical and location based, routing based services, this fields service management is going to help you in a very good extent. We have made this in Udu, and our mobile application is there in Android. So we would like to hear your feedback, and when we are going to push up the demo live, and we'll keep everyone posted about it. Thank you very much for your time. Have a good day.